after De Niro screams Trump's a effing idiot, fed-up Americans give him brutal surprise. Robert De Niro was in front of a packed house, including children, when he mentally lost it on stage. The aging leftist celebrity was presenting fellow actress Meryl Streep with a Best Actress Award at the National Board of Review Annual Awards Gala in New York when he launched into a profanity-laced tirade about President Donald Trump. De Niro's epic meltdown seems to be the final straw as fed-up Americans gave him a brutal surprise. Robert De Niro is finding out the hard way that Americans are sick and tired of the Hollywood crowd attacking President Donald Trump. De Niro, who thinks he is an actual mafia don, displayed barbaric and profane language in his descriptions of Trump as his sick obsession with the president caused him to lose his mind on stage. The 74-year-old actor took to the stage to present fellow Trump hater Meryl Streep with the Best Actress Award from the National Board of Review for her role in The Post. With notes in hand, De Niro looked agitated as he tried to stay on topic, which was Meryl Streep. Finally, he put the notes aside and launched into a profane tirade about Trump, as the transcript provided by the Daily Mail proves. Meryl is the most generous and giving actor. She not only inhabits her own character, she helps bring out the character of everyone else on the screen. Can a volleyball do that? De Niro said, referencing the Tom Hanks movie Castaway. Not even if the volleyball was a stable genius. It was fascinating to watch The Post. That story took place nearly 50 years ago, but there are many parallels with today, obviously. That triggered the leftist loser to start his hate-filled tirade, ranting, "At the time of the story, Donald Trump was suffering with bone spurs. Today, the world is suffering from the real Donald Trump. Come on. You know. What are we talking about?" He continued before completely losing it. "This effing idiot is the president. It's the emperor's new clothes, the guy is a effing fool." Sadly, he wasn't finished as a stunned audience, including two of Angelina Jolie's young kids, looked on. The publication of the Pentagon Papers was a proud moment for American journalism. The Times and the Post challenged the government over critical First Amendment issues. And the press prevailed. Our government today, with the propping up of our baby-in-chief, the jerk-off-in-chief, I call him, has put the press under siege, trying to discredit it through outrageous attacks and lies, added the reality challenge De Niro. What the idiots in the Hollywood crowd don't get is that they serve at the pleasure of the people. Simply put, they work for us. And Bobby De Niro just sank whatever goodwill he had left with Americans who were once his fans. There is a time and a place and a way to register your protest of the President of the United States, and it's not at some awards show where kids are present as you use disgusting metaphors and inappropriate language about the Commander-in-Chief. De Niro is facing a tidal wave of backlash from his audience, the American people. One ex-fan, who goes by Tarmac492 on Twitter, tweeted, "Scorsese and scriptwriters made Robert De Niro a tough guy. When left to his own devices, he sounds like the angry, old drunk at the bar who hasn't had a decent bowel movement in 10 years. Twitter user Tefrote, "When I saw Robert De Niro trending, I thought, oh no, he's dead. Turns out it's his career. His foul-mouthed, disgustingly classless rant on President Trump just described himself and his relationship with Harvey Weinstein. Hash, he knew. Yep. Poor Bobby. Pretty sure his real employers, the American people, are done with his tantrums and his on tirades." As Tracy, a former fan who weighed in, tweeted, "Robert De Niro running his mouth again about President Trump has made sure any movie he's in from now on will be a flop. Hollywood slash pedo wood slash rape wood doesn't get it. I'm loving watching them crash and burn. Watching them make a spectacle of themselves is way better than their movies." The Golden Globe Awards ratings hit a 6-year low a few days ago, and that bodes badly for the entire entertainment industry. Just like the NFL players taking a knee, these privileged, overrated, ego-driven losers in Hollywood are speaking in an echo chamber. Just who in the hell does Robert De Niro think he is? He reads other people's words as he acts out a role for our entertainment. How does that give him the license to call Donald Trump anything other than Mr. President? That goes for all of those idiots, too. Whether they are acting out a role, singing a song for our pleasure, or throwing a football for our amusement, they are finding out the hard way it's better to keep their traps shut because we will boycott everything they do from now on.